And here is the Writer's Almanac for Saturday. It's the 14th of August, 2021. It's the birthday of Alice Adams, born Fredericksburg, Virginia, 1926. Grew up in Chapel Hill. Her dad was a professor there. Went to Radcliffe, got married, moved to San Francisco, had a son, was divorced a few years later, and Alice Adams started writing. She wrote 11 novels, Superior Women, Caroline's Daughters, A Southern Exposure, and books of short stories as well. It's the birthday of Russell Baker, the humorist, born Morrisonville, Virginia, 1925, won the Pulitzer Prize for his New York Times column, The Observer, and another Pulitzer for his autobiography, Growing Up. It was on this day, 1935, the original Social Security Act was passed, part of the New Deal, and Social Security numbers were introduced for keeping track of taxes paid into the system. Now people usually fill out their child's Social Security application along with the birth certificate. So Social Security numbers have become the de facto identification number of everyone in America. It's the birthday of the novelist Danielle Steele, born in New York City, 1947, who lives in San Francisco, where she writes her books on a 1948 metal body Olympia manual typewriter, often writing for 18 hours a day, working on several books at once. Grew up in a rich, globe-trotting family, married a wealthy French banker. When she was young, they kept homes in Paris, New York, and San Francisco. She worked at an ad agency. One of her clients was an editor at the Ladies' Home Journal, who encouraged her to write a novel. First book was called Going Home, came out in 1973, did not get very good reviews, and her next five manuscripts were rejected by publishers. But gradually, she got the knack of it. And she made it into the Guinness Book of World Records for having a book on the Times bestseller list for 381 consecutive weeks. And it's the birthday of John Galsworthy, born in Surrey, England, 1867, author of the Forsyte Saga, novels about British upper-middle-class families. He came from a wealthy family, went to Oxford to study law, spent most of his time playing cricket and soccer, but passed the bar exam about the same time a love affair ended. And broken-hearted, Galsworthy decided to leave England, leave the legal life, and travel the world. In the South Seas in 1893, he met Joseph Conrad, and Galsworthy began to write books, at first under a pseudonym and then under his own name. The books in the Forsyte Saga came out in the 1920s. In 1932, he won the Nobel Prize and used the money to help establish the organization PEN, the letters standing for Poet, Essayist, and Novelist. He was offered a knighthood but refused, saying that he didn't think writers should take titles. John Galsworthy, who said, "Where beauty was, nothing ever ran quite straight," which no doubt was why so many people looked on it as immoral. Here's a poem by William Blake, The Smile. There is a smile of love, and there is a smile of deceit, and there is a smile of smiles in which these two smiles meet. And there is a frown of hate, and there is a frown of disdain, and there is a frown of frowns which you strive to forget in vain. For it sticks in the heart's deep core, and it sticks in the deep backbone. And no smile that ever was smiled, but only one smile alone, that betwixt the cradle and grave it only once smiled can be. But when it once is smiled, there's an end to all misery. A poem by William Blake, The Smile. That's the Writer's Almanac for Saturday, August the 14th. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.